Hello and welcome dear students of TY BSc Computer Science. I am Dr. M.N. Shelar from Department of Computer Science. In this semester, I am going to teach subject programming in Java, which is a paper number 5 of TY BSc Computer Science. In this video, I will present first the structure of syllabus for this semester and we'll start with first chapter. Initially, we'll cover the brief history of Java, then what are the different features of Java. If you see the syllabus, there are 8 chapters or units available in this semester. The first chapter, an introduction. Here we will cover the history as well as features of Java. Then we'll compare the Java with C++, another object-oriented programming language that you have already studied in last year. Then we'll brief with Java platform, what are the different Java tools available, and at last in this chapter we'll see how to write a simple Java program, how to compile and how to execute it. In second chapter, an overview of Java. I will discuss first data types, then different operators as well as control flow statements, how to create array and how to use array in Java program, that will be covered in this chapter, as well as command line arguments and how to take input from the user in Java programs. In third chapter, objects and classes, how to create objects as well as how to define methods in class, what are the different static fields or static methods and static blocks will be also be covered. Then wrapper classes as well as object as a class will also covered in this chapter. Then concept of packages, that is a collection of classes. This topic will be covered in this chapter number 3. In chapter 4, inheritance and interface, we'll go through how to define, how to create inheritance in Java. Already inheritance topic is covered in C++, which are the different types of inheritance, how to override methods. Then concept of polymorphism, how to use the dynamic binding, all these topics will be covered in this chapter. Interface is the new concept available, which was not there in C++. As Java is not providing multiple inheritance, instead interfaces are to be used. How to create interface, how to implement them, that will be covered in this chapter. As well as how to clone different objects and as well as inner classes. These topics will also be covered in this chapter 4. Next, in chapter 5, exception handling. So, exceptions are nothing but runtime errors which are generated during execution of programs. How exceptions are handled, how to define the exception classes, how to use the predefined classes, that will be covered. How to create our own exception classes, these topics will be covered in this chapter. And at last in this chapter we'll see assertions. Next chapter, strings, streams and files. It covers string class. String is one of the class available in Java, how to use those classes in our program. Additional another string buffer class also we covered here. Then file class, how to do file handling with the help of streams. There are mainly two types of streams, byte streams and character streams. Those will also be covered in this chapter. Then in next chapter 7, how to develop Java applications with the help of graphical user interface, GUI based components, using two different libraries, that is AWT and Swing. AWT stands for Abstract Window Toolkit. How to define GUI components, how MVC architecture is used in these components in Swing library, that will also be covered here. How to design screens with the help of different GUI components, how to handle the exceptions for developing different Java applications. Then in last chapter, applets, we will go through another type of program, Java program, that is applet. Applets are the programs which are running on web browsers. How to create our own applets? What is the life cycle? How to pass parameter to the applet programs? All these topics will also be covered in this chapter. So this is the overall structure of syllabus that we are going to study in this semester. Now let us start with the first chapter of this paper, Introduction to Java. In this video, we'll cover first the basic history and the main features of Java. Now, as you know, current programming problems are becoming more complex today. Even structured programming cannot handle or cannot manage those complexities easily. Therefore, we use object-oriented programming, which makes it possible to organize complex programs using different concepts or different features like classes, inheritance, polymorphism, and so on. As you know, C++, it's one of the object-oriented programming language. Before Java, it was very popular for writing object-oriented programs. However, due to the advent of internet, Java became widely used nowadays in recent years. The Java is basically a pure object-oriented programming. It is a full-fledged programming language and platform to build a powerful, distributed, and secure applications. Now, we'll go to the history of Java. C and C++ languages were not suitable for developing programs as a platform independent, because the programs have to be compiled for the specific hardware before execution. And the compiled code cannot run on any other processor that again has to be recompiled whenever it is to be run on another processor. So the main motivation of Java was to develop a platform independent language to create embedded software for consumer electronic devices. In attempt to find the platform independent solution, Sun Microsystems began work on a language that could be used to create code that would run on variety of processors under different environments. So in 1991, Sun Microsystems developed a language. It was named as Oak. And later on in 1995, it is renamed to Java. Around the same time, World Wide Web was becoming popular. The web required platform independent programs which could be executed on any machine irrespective of its hardware and software configuration. So Java developer realized that an architectural neutral language that would be ideal for programming on the internet. And during that period, the focus of Java changed from consumer electronic devices to the internet. So Java is not only a programming language, it is a technology that enables the development of secure, high performance and highly robust applications on multiple platforms in heterogeneous as well as distributed networks. It was just a brief history of Java. Let us come towards what are the features of Java? Why the Java technology has become popular? Because of these different features. So if you see the features here, Java is simple, it is object oriented, it is used in distributed environment, it is a robust language, interpreter is used, it's portable and architectural neutral, we can develop a secure applications, multi-threading environment. So these are the different features. We'll go one by one in detail. Java is a simple. Yes, it is simple as compared to C++ language. Because Java has omitted the features, some features which are complex and confusing, which was used in C++, like preprocessor, operator overloading, multiple inheritance, etc. There are some error-prone tasks such as pointers and memory management. Those tasks have been eliminated in Java explicitly. We need not have to define a pointers. We need not have to manage the memory. Java internally handles the pointers as well as memory management features. So Java is more simpler than C++. Second feature is object-oriented. Yes, it is object-oriented programming language like a C++. But difference is that Java has been designed as a pure object-oriented programming language. Whereas in C++ is a combination of procedural as well as object-oriented programming language. Java includes all features which were used in other object-oriented programming concepts like class, objects, encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, dynamic binding, and all. And you know, object-oriented programming language enables reusability of code and extensibility to create dynamic applications. Next feature of Java is distributed. Means Java programs can be distributed and accessed over the network. Because Java supports various networking protocols such as TCP/IP, UDP, file transfer protocol, and others. Therefore, Java can be used to develop applications which can be used on network. Java applications can access objects using URLs and also invoke remote methods using RMI. Next feature of Java is that we can develop secure applications with the help of Java language. Java addresses various security issues by putting in place a very rigorous multi-level system of security. It enforces security by restricting access to different resources. It eliminates the pointer. And so Java ensures that user cannot access and modify the data in memory because pointers are not explicitly used by programmers or users. Next feature is Java is architectural neutral and portable. Basically, if you see the figure here, the Java source code is compiled by Java compiler, and Java compiler generates a bytecode instructions. It does not generate a machine code directly. It generates a bytecode. What is a bytecode? Bytecode is an intermediate between source and native machine code. And bytecode is a neutral. Yes, it is not depend on computer architecture or machine. It has nothing to do with a particular computer machine. So this bytecode is converted by Java virtual machines into native code for a particular processor. How this Java virtual machine converts it? This is converted with the help of Java interpreter. So by porting an interpreter for Java virtual machine to any computer or any hardware or operating system, we can assure that all code compiled for one machine can run on other system. Therefore, once you compile your program on one computer, generates a bytecode, carry that program, bytecode instruction program to on another platform or another machine, JVM will be there. Java interpreter interprets that with the help of JVM and generates a machine code. Means Java programs are compiled as well as interpreted. This is another six feature. Java compiler converts Java program to bytecode instruction, and Java interpreter converts bytecode instruction into platform specific code and that executes it. Let us go to the next feature. Multi-threading. What is multi-threading? It is an ability of an application to execute more than one thread or task at the same time. Means it is possible to create multi-threaded applications in Java. Java uses a thread. That's why it utilizes resources, CPU and memory simultaneously. Means one application can be divided into multiple tasks or called as a threads at the same time. Those threads will run simultaneously. And those threads simultaneously utilizes a CPU idle time as well as memory and other resources. Now next feature is Java is a dynamic. Java is designed to adapt to an ever-changing environment. Means during the execution of program, Java can dynamically load required classes. It is not going to load all classes before execution of the program. It loads the classes as and when required. Therefore, it reduces the overhead as well as it reduces the memory requirement, and it improves definitely the performance of the application which is running. So these are the main features of Java that we have seen, and because of those features, Java become more popular language. So this all about the brief history we have covered, the features of Java, and in next video we are going to cover comparison of Java and C++, as well as we are going to cover the Java tools, Java environment, and we'll start with Java programs in the next video. Thank you.